A bronze medal then up for grabs in the women's doubles. And it's two very unlikely candidates, isn't it? Valeria Sorokina and Nina Vislova of Russia up against Alex Bruce and Michelle Lee of Canada. Never before have either country, Russia or Canada, won a medal in badminton at the Olympics. That is about to change. Incredible week it's been in the women's doubles, Jill. Of course, it's been a pretty low point, but this is the high point now because the beneficiaries are these pairs.
Yes, indeed. Very sad for the sport of badminton earlier on in the competition. And of course, hit the headlines around the world, the fact that four women's doubles pairs were expelled from the games for not giving best efforts in the last of their group matches. But as you say, not only have Russia and Canada never played for a medal or won a medal in badminton doubles, I think even more surprising is the fact that all 16 previous women's doubles medals have gone to just two nations previously, China and Korea. So this is a very good sign. It may come about in strange circumstances, but a very, very good sign that it will have new countries involved in medals.
And if you're a romantic, it's a wonderful story, really. Valeria Sorokina and Nina Vislova, the Russian pair here. Well, they have achieved much already. First ever European champions from Russia. They won that a couple of years ago. But for their opponents today, well, unbelievable week they have had. Alex Bruce and Michelle Lee didn't win a game in any of their matches, failed to win more than 12 points in the group stages. But how life has changed for them since. They are now national heroes back home. They were a continental slot, supposedly making up the numbers. Yet here they are, coming up with a chance to win a medal. Fair to say, the worst scandal in badminton history, but it's turned out to be the best news for badminton in Canada. And in some respect, Jill, the pressure really is on Sorokina and Vislova. They know they may never get a better chance of winning a medal. They are a highly talented pair. They're the favourites here. But Michelle Lee and Alex Bruce showed in their quarterfinal against Fujin Kakawa. They may have got thrashed by this pair earlier in the week, but they may be a different proposition here this morning.
Yes, it was actually in the semi-final that they played against Fuji and Kakiwa. Three absolutely tremendous games. You know, sport is all about grasping opportunities, and these two pairs, having thought they were out of the competition, have embraced this second chance. And really, I mean, as you say, it's a wonderful, wonderful story. But you're right, all the pressure is on the Russians. They've been as high as number four in the world rankings, former European champions, and they are expected to win this. But the Canadians have shown great form.
Well, I mean, both pairs obviously thought they were going home. They actually met in the group stages, and the scoreline was 21-8, 21-10 to the Russians, which suggests, doesn't it, that it's going to be another one-sided show. But my goodness, life has changed for Alex Bruce and Michelle Lee since then. On Tuesday after that defeat to the Russians, they went out, they did some sightseeing, they met up with the family, they were kept away from the news by their coach as well, whereas Vislova and Sorokina were very much aware of what was going on. Hopeful that they might have a route back in. Of course, the week started brilliantly for Sorokina, who we just saw them, and she won in the mixed doubles alongside Nikolaenko. This is how things have happened. As you can see, Wang Xiaoli and Wu Yang and Jungmin Kim of Korea, two of the pairs that were disqualified. which is why these two both made it through to the quarter-final stage, and well, both won. Comfortable win for the Russians in their quarter-final. Here is Michelle Lee, who is a talented singles player. She played in the singles, got beat by Wang Yihan, who's in the women's singles final. 20-year-old born in Hong Kong. And here's the 22-year-old Alex Bruce, who said she's never had so many notifications on her social media account over the last few days. The whole of Canada watching their semi-final, which, as you can see, against Fujin Kakiwa, well, they played best, well, they say the best badminton they've ever played together. They are playing better, they're communicating better, they're, well, as I say, they've never been, I mean, they are, you know, they're no mugs, they're ranked 27 in the world, but they have benefited big time from what has been not the most pleasant of stories here this week. So ago the Canadians were suffering from food poisoning, yet that's all forgotten now. Went to Canada Olympic House, spent some time with family and friends, had a sleep in Wednesday morning, took it nice and easy, and it wasn't until 1 o'clock in the afternoon that coach let them know, there he is, Ramnea, that they would probably be reinstated. He didn't want to tell them, didn't want to get them too nervous. And, it proved to be the right formula as they beat the Aussies of Anuga Viren and the Anchu. So Valeria Sorokina and Nina Vislova. Introduced here now by our coach from Great Britain, Jane Hancock. Predicted this at the start of the week. Canada against Russia for bronze in the women's doubles. Fair to say the Canadians were best known for their names, of course. Put them together, you get Bruce Lee. But it's less about karate, but more about badminton now. The Russians take the first point, though. History, the Russians. Well, before these games, the best a Russian had ever done was the men's doubles pair in 96 when Andrei Antropov and Nikolai Zuyev reached the second round of the men's doubles. Now he's involved, isn't he, Zuyev, in coaching this pair?
Yes, indeed. Zuyev, not here though in London, but he has been heavily involved in coaching these two Russian women.
If you'd have told these four players when they met on Tuesday, well, you'd be back again for the bronze medal match on Saturday, I think they'd have laughed you away and called you crazy and sent you to the nearest asylum. Here we are, though. The Russians have settled quicker.
Serve, wasn't it?
Yeah, she Canadians feel that she's a real talent, Michele Lee, not just here in the women's doubles, but as well as in the singles as well.
It's not just the Canadians that think that, I think that too. Very, very talented youngster.
She didn't have the greatest draw, did she, in the women's singles? Bit of a match coming up in the final, but some crowd support, the Canadians. But it's been, I think, a pretty impressive display so far from Sorokina and Vislova.
Good rally.
Yeah, a few excited Canadians, as you'd expect, inside Wembley Arena. Enjoyed this one. This. Something like cult status heroes, haven't they? in a week in London. Well left by Vislova. Just shows you, though, you don't know what's around the corner. You scraping around for funding, you're living with your parents, nobody knows, you're not even in your home city, and suddenly they'll go home. Whatever happens here is household names. Well, it's a good lead, isn't it, for the Russians, though. Maria Sorokina, Nina Vislova, 11-6 to the good.
You guys talked about this when you were preparing. You said we have to hit down in the middle of the court, right? That's where we have to go. How do you get that? It's really simple. No soft shots. The first shot that we hit has to have pace. It doesn't have to be perfect, though. It just has to have pace, right? Because they're waiting for that slow one and jumping on. Okay? Yep. Pace on the shots. Come on, go.
What do you think of that, Julian?
Well, it's quite clear what his instruction is. He wants them to hit down the middle. Very, very sensible tactics in doubles. It narrows the angle of your pie, and also if you can hit down in between your opponents, obviously there's a chance they could get confused as to which one should be playing it. But also saying that the first one had to be played with pace. I suppose if you do that, then if you vary the pace after that, then your opponents are likely to be standing back in court a little bit more, and therefore more vulnerable to the slower shot.
Well, hit with some pace.
Set each other up so well, this Russian pair, getting the net player involved.
Pretty good form coming into this event, the Russians. Finals at the recent US Open, it's off the back of winning the Russian Open Grand Prix event.
Clever placement of the smash across the body of Alex Bruce.
Yeah, as we mentioned before this match got underway, there's real pressure and expectancy on the shoulders of Sorokina and Vislova. They've handled it very well. Seems to be pretty pleased so far. Case, wasn't it, that we thought we were going to see a different Canadian pair to the ones that were swept away by the Russians on Tuesday. But it could be a very similar scoreline in this first game. Have arrived, and it's only taken 12 minutes. And there we go, 21-9, that's pretty comprehensive. And maybe this whirlwind romantic story is catching up with Michele Lee and Alex Bruce here. And all credit to Sorokina and Vislova. They have played excellent badminton. Easy in the moment, isn't it, Drew, on these two have done that.
Yeah, they certainly have so far.
To somehow find the badminton they've been playing over the last few days. So the Russian pair hit on the brink of history, it would seem. Canadians need more of that. They've got the crowd support here, that's for sure.
Well, it was the second game in their semi-final where they really blossomed, the Canadians. They lost the opening game to the Japanese pair.
It's interesting how it works psychology-wise, isn't it? You know, weren't expecting to be there. Boom, boom, relishing it, and now suddenly, ooh, we could win ourselves a medal. It seems like it's worked like that.
Yeah, the realization of the enormity of the situation. And also, of course, playing against the Japanese pair, absolutely no pressure. Unused to playing against that particular Japanese pair, whereas, as you rightly say, these two pairs met in the group. So they know their opponents, they know they've lost badly to their opponents. So again, the psychology of that, I think, is playing a part.
Yeah, and their opponents as well know where their weak spots are. And obviously there was a few exposed when they did meet only a few days ago. What was it, 3 or 4 days ago? Days all seem to roll in one, don't they? Yeah, this is... turning into the perfect match at the moment for Vislova and Sorokina.
Oh, that's nice.
They're moving so well across the court, aren't they?
Yeah. And Valeria Sorokina finishing it off on that occasion, as she so often does. You were mentioning the fact that she's played here in London mixed doubles as well with Alexander Nikolayenko. And her expertise in mixed doubles, the need for good net play and domination of the front of the court is shining through in this women's doubles as well. There we are again, good interception.
Excellent shot from Vislova too. Fairy tales have a happy ending, but I suppose Michelle Lee and Alex Bruce, whatever happens here, will have a few tales to tell. And it's whatever happened being a big boost for badminton in Canada, but badminton in Russia, Jill, has certainly been on the up, hasn't it, the last few years, and this will be a huge boost for them.
Yes, absolutely. It's especially the women's squad have done particularly well in Europe for some time, and obviously culminating in the European title for this particular women's doubles pair, but they've also had some very good singles players. Prokopenko played here at the Olympics. She's a fine athlete too.
It's a sport that's been played in Russia for many years. I think they've had a national championship there since the 1960s. Of course, under the old communist regime, it was seen as a sport for all.
Yeah, some big publicity recently because now President Putin is playing badminton and encouraged all the service personnel to play badminton too. He said it was a very, very good all-round test of physical ability.
He's right, isn't he?
He is.
We've seen here this week, any of you watching for the first time, I'm sure you're impressed by the skills, the stamina of these players. That time it's out. A point on the board for the Canadians.
Have the most extraordinary sort of hitting action, doesn't she, Nina Vislova? Big swing of the racket, almost a sort of windmill action, isn't it? Winds it up, but very, very effective.
Well, Peterson and Fisher yesterday won Europe's first medal in badminton since 2004. They guaranteed another medal, the Danes, of course, with in the men's doubles. It looks like Europe could be winning another medal here. There seems to be no stopping Sorokina and Vislova right now. Bit of a break, couldn't they, the Canadian pair? Got one there. That's 6 points the lead for the Russians, and the interval comes up pretty quickly again. As I was suggesting before, I think we might see a similar scoreline to the one we did see on Tuesday. It was 21-8, 21-10. Doubles badminton, hasn't it? More written about it than anyone could have perceived. Obviously not for the right reasons. But it's going to be two young ladies from Russia by the looks of things. Nice put away there by Bruce. But they're going to be the two players who are going to benefit most from it all. 2 points in a row then by the Canadians. They can at least push the Russians in this game. Michelle Lee and Alex Bruce just to lessen what would be sure disappointment if they are swept aside again.
Placement of the attacking play from the former European champions.
That's a nice touch, isn't it?
Attacking play in their semi-final, which was so impressive. They were given more opportunities, the Japanese pair, very content at times to defend, whereas today in this bronze medal playoff match, the Russians are looking to attack at every possible opportunity.
Just wide. 7 points now, the lead. Good call.
Game, but in all honesty, she created her own luck there, Valeria Sorokina.
Running out of patience. 3 points away from a medal now. Well, it's as comprehensive as they could have imagined here. The dream looks to be ending here for Michelle Lee and Alex Bruce. What a week it's been for them. But it's glory that's heading Russia's way here. And Valerina Sorokina and Nina Vislova have 10 match points to take the bronze medal in the women's doubles at London 2012. It's history in the making for Russian badminton. Their first ever Olympic medal in badminton. Valerina Sorokina and Nina Vislova have won the bronze medal, and in a convincing manner. And incredibly, the Canadian pair only won one more point than they did when they met this Russian pair on Tuesday. Well, unfortunately, they couldn't produce their best like they did in the quarterfinal and semi-final, but all credit, Jill, to this Russian pair who just didn't allow the Canadians to get going here.
No, they did exceptionally well because all the pressure was on them. They were expected to win, but they came out today very, very positive. And as you said earlier on, I think perhaps the enormity of the situation finally hit the Canadians, and they looked a little bit tentative, a little bit nervous. But, you know, what a tournament for both these pairs. It really has been a roller coaster ride.
So confirmation then. It was a very one-sided affair. Valeria Sorokina and Nina Vislova beating Alex Bruce and Michele. 21-9, 21-10. Didn't take long, did it? 27 minutes in total. That was one-sided. I think the Russians will mind about that one level drop. European champions and now Olympic bronze medalists.